As you may already know, the new KS Corona came out at the end of the last week. I have quickly tested and checked out the new features, so I can show you all of this as quickly as possible. Also, big thanks to Rebus Farm for sponsoring this video. Before Corona Decals, to create footprints like here, we had to create special maps by ourselves. It's a bit of a big and forward process and it takes time. However, with Corona Decals, it's just easier and you have more control. Until now, the process of creating, for example, blended displacement was long and it's not an issue anymore. By the way, if you want to learn more about Corona Decals and how to use them, watch my tutorial. I put the link in the corner and in the description below the video. I already loaded the footprints material in the scene and applied it to the Corona Decal object. So now, we can add footprints, for example, using maps that maintain the original texture for the ground, like a bump map for instance. So at this moment, only the bump from the Corona Decal objects works. If we want to blend it with the original one, we only have to click Add to Base, next to the bump name. To make it more visible for you, I'll unplug the opacity map for a moment. So now, only the bump from the footprint material is working. And now you can notice the original snow bump visible in those places as well. It works similarly for displacement. Here we go, now it's blending and we can adjust the levels. We can of course make adjustments, but in general, it's a great option to have as it makes the process way faster. We can also make decals visible in the Corona Masking ID render element. So we can use decals now to create brick cracks, for example. We can easily move around and position them without destroying the color and other parameters of the brick. Now we can place the Corona camera whatever we like, including inside volumes such as a volume material, Phoenix simulations or volume grids for open VDB objects. Cameras can, for example, fly through clouds and fog or pass through fire, so we can create awesome animation shots with this effect. Additionally, we should be now able to create shots half in and half out of a volume like in this example. However, I tried it on my scene and the render just froze. I thought it may be an issue with the scene as it was created with one of the previous versions, so I made a simple scene from scratch. So basically, to get this effect, we should use the camera's physical size in the Environment and Clipping tab in the camera settings. By turning on the Show in the viewport, we can actually see the changes. We can adjust the size. But you can see that the render is just frozen, so I couldn't make it. Let me know if you have a similar issue or if you know how to solve it. Anyway, I just wanted to show you how it will work in real life to get similar results. Photographers use special DOM boards. So this is how you get these results. Now we have an experimental option that improves the look of the blurring of any highlights, both reflections and directly viewed lights. Here you can see the comparison of the render with and without the option. Now, adding the debuff field in your images and animations always adds realism, but on the other hand, it also adds extra time for rendering. If you don't have a good enough computer or you are running out of time, the great solution will be using some extra help like Rebus Farm. They are perfect for RVs artists because they support all the popular software, but most importantly, they have all the plugins we need, so there won't be any unpleasant surprises. There are no hidden costs. You know how much you will pay for every render if you use their cost estimation tool. They're also great people. They have 24/7 human support, so if you encounter any issues during the process, they will quickly solve the problem for you. And the best part is that you can get started with their free trial. I put a link to their website in the corner and in the description below the video so you can check them out and sign up for your free trial. If we choose to use the direct color for the Corona Sun, now this will affect the procedural clouds in the Corona sky as well. This gives us the possibility to have more control and we can, for instance, add reddish tint to the clouds without having them low to the horizon. We can create very abstract images this way. But if we use light colors like here, for example, we can add just a tiny bit of color to the clouds if we wish. Or by adding the dark blue color, we can create a nighttime image with moonlight pretty quickly. We need to adjust the tone mapping or light mix a bit. But still, we can quickly turn our images into different times without even changing the sun's position. This option can be great for quick previews for clients. The current lister is updated and now has new options in it included. We can, for example, see all the cameras in the scene and we can change their parameters from here. So we don't have to go to the camera settings one by one, you can change them here. Another category is displacement. We can see all the materials with the displacement as well as objects with the displacement modifiers listed. Similarly, you can change the settings from here. Pretty handy. Lights were always here, however the look changed a bit, and we have new options. Proxies are great. As soon as I have one in the scene, I have it on the list. A great option is to change the preview type. Especially for all proxies at once. Before, I had to use the script to do that. Now, it's in Corona. The changes to Chaos Scatter Lister have been made as well. It gets a new look and has some new options. The Chaos tool make improvements to caustic, they will now render brighter and be more accurate and detailed. You can see the comparison here. One smaller improvement, but I love it. Now we can add multiple maps to Corona Color Correction, Corona Mapping Randomize map, which changed the name from UVW Randomizer, and Corona Tree Planner. I will definitely use the Color Correction map to adjust leaves materials at once. This will be a huge time saver. So we can just add how many inputs we need and plug all the maps into it. Then, we need to plug adequate outputs into the right slots, and that's it. I will use it for diffuse color maps, but also for transfluency. A lot of times models need adjustments depending on the scene, and this is great to save some time. With one map we can control the whole tree, which makes life so much easier. Now, there is an additional option when setting up the light mix automatically. Layers, which lets you have one light select for each layer in the scene. There are also performance updates like a faster material editor, improvement performing when rendering the masks, and so on. It's not a huge update with game changer options, but these improvements will help us make more realistic images and animations, as well as making them more efficiently. If you want to learn all about visualizations and animations in 3ds Max and Corona, visit our website. Also, watch other helpful videos here on YouTube. Bye bye!